My name's Dr. Tan.
Hi, how are you? You can call me Jerry.
Nice to meet you, Jerry.
Hi, I'm Aliza.
Some people have said that geriatrics is nothing if not a team enterprise.
Well, I've been having some problems.
Working in a silo doesn't work for that older patient. By definition, the problems that they are coming to you with as a psychologist, or that they would come to their physician with.
And she's worried that, I'm forgetful enough.
Are often problems that have biological and psychological and social determinants.
Jacoby Hospital's in the Bronx. It's an amazingly diverse population. We have patients from all over the world. We run what we call a medicine psychology, geropsychology consultation clinic here at Jacoby, and that's the training site for the geropsychology externs as part of the Furkoff Older Adults Program.
What do you do in therapy?
In the med psych clinic, we have patients who are referred from our own adult medical primary care practice and adult medical specialty practices. And so those are the patients that we see in this clinic.
Students who train here in primary care train and deliver services to older adults as part of an integrated team. That integrated team typically includes, at the least, medical residents and the psychology trainee. They are literally at times in the same room together with patients, learning from each other, as well as delivering integrated services to a patient. They are supervised jointly in real time by both a psychology professional as well as a medical professional.
And we're happy to figure out with you what's going on.
It's been really great to be in this kind of multidisciplinary environment. We're able to be very independent while we're in training, and then we present each case to our supervisors. It's usually a team. Like, there'll be some residents there, there'll be both supervisors present, so we really get all the input when we're doing the supervision, and then we come back to the patient and finish up the session. And then afterwards we'll kind of connect with social work or whoever we need for resources.
The other thing that I think is worthy of a little bit more exploration, the psychologists bring that depth of understanding and that sophistication and the nuances of assessing cognitive functioning, both instrumental functioning and other functioning in the lives of our patients.
The modal patient that we see is a patient who has not been seen in the mental health services before, not had any type of, professional consultation before, and may not even think of their problem as a behavioral problem. And so we train our medical residents and doctoral trainees to understand how to begin the conversation with such a patient.
Before my time in the medicine psych clinic, I was personally very afraid of patients who had psychiatric conditions. I did not know how to approach them in a manner that was meaningful, both for the patients and for my time with the patient. What questions or concerns do you have? Most definitely, I am more sensitive to a patient's psychosocial world. What's going on in their homes, for example, what's going on in their workplace, for example.
One of the benefits of us being an integrated care site is that at least coming to the clinic, a little bit of the stigma is lowered because they're going to the same place they used to go to just for their regular doctor. And so when they come in, the patient may not themselves know exactly why they were referred. They'll often say, my doctor, just told me to come. And so when we get a full sense of what's going on, then we can validate all the reasons that they think they're here for, and also all the reasons that we see also might be warranting attention. And so it's kind of a perfect combination that they get to come somewhere familiar, but also address new problems.
Think about the fact that the first several sessions of psychotherapy may be like that. We know from research that caregivers experience significant burden in caring for an older person with cognitive impairment. We know that they are most concerned not about the memory problems, but about the behavioral symptoms that go along with the memory problems, something that psychologists are uniquely equipped to address.
Effective care, I think, in today's world is about teams of people delivering coordinated care, and that we all understand what everyone is doing. And medicine psychology clinic is a perfect example of how a successful coordinated care system might be.